The US Army has named its new land-based hypersonic weapon system Dark Eagle. The Army has indicated that it's confident that the weapon will enter service in 2023. Once deployed, Dark Eagle will provide the US Army with a land-based, long-range capability. Importantly, the weapon will be almost invulnerable to the air defense systems that are now in place. The progress in this is also critical since Russia and China are fielding their own hypersonic weapons, and the US is actually lagging behind in this. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the Dark Eagle hypersonic weapon of the US Army could be an excellent deterrence against Russia and China. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. An object is said to be hypersonic once they exceed the speeds of Mach 5. That's 5 times the speed of sound. This is about 1,715 meters per second, or 3,836 miles per hour, 6,174 kilometers per hour. There are currently 3 methods being applied to make hypersonic weapons. The first is using a scramjet engine. The scramjet is an innovation on the ramjet. Ramjet engines can power flight to supersonic speeds, but scramjet can enable the missiles to reach hypersonic speeds. The scramjet engine can power a hypersonic cruise missile. The second is through the use of ALBM, or air-launched ballistic missiles. As the name suggests, this kind of missile is ballistic in nature, but it's launched from the air, unlike traditional ballistic missiles, which are launched from land or sea-based platforms. The third is using HGV, or hypersonic glide vehicle. In this method, the system is launched to extremely high altitudes using a ballistic missile, where it skips across the Earth's atmosphere. The vehicle then separates from the carrier and glides back to the Earth towards its intended target, attaining hypersonic speed. The glide vehicle could be powered or unpowered. Dark Eagle uses this approach, based on C-HGB, or Common Hypersonic Glide Body. The design of the Common Hypersonic Glide Body is based on the previously developed Alternate Re-entry System, which was tested in the early 2010s as part of the US Army's Advanced Hypersonic Weapon Program. The Alternate Re-entry System was itself based on the Sandia Winged Energetic Re-entry Vehicle Experiment, or SWERV, prototype developed by Sandia National Laboratories in the 1980s. C-HGB includes a conventional warhead, guidance system, cabling, and thermal protection shield. C-HGB will use the booster rocket motor to reach hypersonic speed, jettison the expended rocket booster, and then glide to its target. The US Navy is leading the design, while the US Army is leading the production. The C-HGB has been successfully tested twice, in October 2017 and March 2020. Dark Eagle combines the unpowered Common Hypersonic Glide Body, CHGB, with a large rocket booster. The missile has a range of 1,700 miles, or around 2,735 kilometers. As per reports, the US Army will deploy Dark Eagle in artillery batteries of 8 missiles each. That will consist of 4 truck-bound transporter erector launcher vehicles with 2 missiles each, plus a control and operation center. The mobility will ensure that the system won't be easily taken out by preemptive strikes. Also, the relatively compact size means that aircraft like C-130J Super Hercules will transport the system, allowing quick deployment in the required battle space. Dark Eagle will combine the high speed of a ballistic missile with the maneuverability of a cruise missile, making it almost unstoppable. Hypersonic weapons are currently being pursued mainly by America, Russia, China, France, and India. Russia is at the forefront of hypersonic weapons. It's reached an advanced level with two hypersonic weapons, Kinzhal and Avangard. The Kinzhal, or Dagger, is an ALBM, or air-launched ballistic missile. According to the Russian president, units in the country's southern military district, which borders Ukraine and the Black Sea, have deployed the missiles operationally. Avangard is a nuclear-tipped hypersonic boost glide vehicle. Earlier this year, Russian Defense Minister Sergei Shoigu stated that the first missile unit equipped with the Avangard had entered combat duty. China has developed DF-17 missile along with DF-ZF hypersonic glide vehicle. DF-17, or Dongfeng-17, is a Chinese solid-fueled, road-mobile, medium-range ballistic missile that mounts on the DF-ZF hypersonic glide vehicle. The DF-17 and DF-ZF were officially unveiled at the National Day Military Parade on the 1st of October, 2019. President Biden's administration is not only keeping several of President Trump's weapons development programs in place, but it's also seeking to expand a few of these. One of these is the hypersonic weapon, as the U.S. plays catch-up. Dark Eagle could be the first step when it comes to restoring the balance when it comes to hypersonic weapons. Strategically, it will add a lot of teeth to the U.S. Army. Dark Eagle could be used to target positions across the South China Sea and even deep into China when launched from positions in the Philippines, Vietnam, and Japan. Similarly, if deployed in Europe, it could cover a significant part of Russia in its strike envelope. It remains to be seen how things will pan out in the coming days. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.